Looking to transmute some unwanted cards into a booster box? Look no further than ChannelFireball.com's online buy list. We offer competitive prices on cards from Ancestral Recall to Zombie Master, and we send payments fast via check or PayPal. If you're not looking for cash, we offer a 30% store credit bonus. Head to ChannelFireball.com/buylist to submit your buy order. It's faster and easier than winning with a pack rat.
All right, time for a cube Swiss draft such that no matter how off the deep end we go, we're still going to be able to have three rounds. So that's pretty exciting. As for this pack, reanimate would be an interesting first pick. If we wanted to go the reanimation route, it only costs black, which makes it really powerful. And it's in kind of a weaker pack. Sphinx's Revelation is calling me, but all these other kind of... none of these other cards are really doing it for me. I'm only looking at the Revelation and the Reanimate, and I think I'm going to take the Revelation. It's just... It's more fun and more open than Reanimate to me, even though it's in more colors. But everything else in the pack is just a step down in power level, I feel, which is not very exciting. So, start with our Mythic Bomb here. And Kiora, wow, this pack's really fun. We see Kiora, we see Garrick, Tidings, Everflowing Chalice. Chalice is pretty good with the Sphinx's Revelation, and I may even be leaning towards it just on account of how little ramp there is in the cube outside of green. There's very little, so there's actually more Kiora and Garrick type effects. As you can tell, there's actually two in the pack, and there's only one Chalice. So I'm going to take the Chalice here. I wouldn't fault anyone for taking the Kiora or the Tidings, and if I didn't know the cube a little bit better, I would definitely take the Kiora, I think. Goes nicely with Sphinx's Rev. But since I'm aware that there really aren't very many mana rocks, I'm just going to jump on any of them that I see. Here we have a pack with a lot of strong cards, but none of them that support like a Chalice Rev archetype that much, except for maybe Titan. I don't like Titan too much in cube because usually the lands you get aren't going to win the game, so it's just like a 6-mana ramp spell, but it's pretty sweet, and I think I'd be willing to take it because, I mean, the white and blue cards are Catastrophe, Exalted Angel, and Negate, and none of those are really that exciting. It's not so early that we have to be base blue-white. Anyways, we could splash Sphinx's Revelation off of Primeval Titan, potentially. I'd love for that to happen. Ooh. This pack, I'm looking at Lotus Bloom. I really like this card. Outside of Storm combo decks and Green Ramp decks, Blue-White Control decks, like just the 3-mana in the mid-game, pretty powerful on this cube. And it works pretty well with Sphinx's Revelation too, so don't have a problem just moving in on that. I noticed at this point how hungry I am, but I guess I'm gonna have to get through the draft itself before I can indulge myself. Okay, so there's a Seaside Citadel, which taps for more colors than Tundra, but Tundra comes into play untapped, and we can fetch it off of some kind of land, presumably, so let's take that. There's no green, white, or blue cards.
Oh, it's 9.
It says 10:40 a.m., but it's actually 9:40. My computer's off. I'm going to take the Tundra, though. Okay. Here we have... I'm going to take the Savannah. There's a good big white card in Sun Titan. And it works well with Lotus Bloom, too. But we already have a Primeval Titan. I'm not sure we need too many more sixes right now. Like, yeah, Savannah's once, I mean, this is the last Savannah we'll see. And Savannah plus Tundra is going to give us tons of options and fetch lands, which should be pretty nice. So I'm going to do that. Although I wouldn't fault Sun Titan being a pick there. It seems pretty good too. I would love to play Obsidot in a deck like this, but we can't. Experiment 1 is not what we want. I'm just kind of moving into a green ramp deck, potentially. Green, blue, white control, potentially. So, I'm just going to keep snapping up the fixing while there's nothing else that exciting. Okay, Hinterland Harbor I would love, but we actually have real magic cards here in Wall of Omens and Palancron. And I think I'm going to take the Wall of Omens, give us something to do in the early game. I do like Hinterland Harbor. I do like Palancron. Palancron would be a nice combo card if we pick up a Heartbeat, which I will look for, but Wall's just a really sturdy early game card. Okay, I'm going to take Augur of Bolas, although I hate it, and we probably won't play it. And as of right now, we don't even have close to enough targets, or rather, things that it can hit, but let's go. Savage Lands, black, green, red. Can't use it. Student of Warfare is in our colors, kind of, but I don't want to play it. And Servitude is an insane magic card that I wouldn't mind having in the deck, and I don't want to play against. It's just, I think this card is super undervalued in general. It's just reusable reanimation is pretty crazy. And this deck has some nasty things it can do. I'm going to take Moment's Peace. Moment's Peace plays nicely with Sphinx's Revelation. Augur of Bolas, so we could turbo land it up. The alternative I see here is Vengevine, which I like, but I don't necessarily want to be that aggressive at the 4-mana slot. Winter Orb, I'm not really looking to splash red. I'll take the Lion's Eye Diamond. Potentially go in a combo direction. Tech Edge would be nice with Primeval Titan, but I'm not going to take it over a Mystic Gate to actually cast our spells. So through pack one, we're missing a win condition. Yeah, we're missing a lot, but it's only pack one, so we've got time.
Well,
this pack is crazy. So first of all, we have Flooded Strand, which gets the Tundra and the Savannah. But there's a Cryptic Command, which is a little bit crazy. There's also Eternal Witness. I don't know how our mana is going to work out, but I'm not going to pass the Cryptic. It's too tasty. Although, the second pick for me would be Flooded Strand over the Eternal Witness, I think. Because good fixing is nice to have, especially if we're trying to play triple blue cards. So let's just dive in. Marsh Flats also gets Tundra and Savannah, so there's going to be a lot of different options for that potentially coming around. And then none of the white cards excite me too much. This Descendant of Kiyomoro card, I've never really seen it in play. I don't really get it. Just a bit awkward card. Interesting. So as for white, blue, green, I don't even know if we're going to play this Titan. Like, it doesn't really look like a Boreal Druid deck. It looks more like a Wall of Reverence deck. However, there's Strip Mine and Reshadenport. Strip Mine and Reshadenport don't play very well with Revelation and Cryptic Command, but they play better in our deck than in our opponent's deck. So, kind of looking at the Strip Mine because I think it's better than Port. Restricted and Vintage, Port isn't. Cloud Skate's good too. Triple Blue, it's just pretty rough on the mana, but this is a good one to get with the Titan also. And none of the spells are that exciting to me. They're okay. Interesting. I'm just gonna snap up the upheaval. We only have the chalice to really make it work, but it's just such a powerful thing. This pack is really nice though, as I also really like the Sylvan Caryatid. But those are the two main cards I would want in the deck. Soldier, Kira, Ulamog, Heliod are all not that exciting to me, but Upheaval and Sylvan, both really spicy. And Upheaval in particular is just going to be, it's going to do, that card is going to do work. All right, it's not too late to move in on Yawgmoth's Will, considering that we have Lion's Eye Diamond and a Lotus Bloom. Mostly just Lion's Eye Diamond is the combo. However, Brain Freeze is in the same pack, and it may or may not come back. I think I'm going to take the Yawg Will because we don't necessarily need Brain Freeze. We could get Emptier Tendrils, and it'd just be so fun if it happened. Can't help it, have to move in. Primal Command is also. A Primal Command is probably the more realistic pick. That or Wood Elves. But I'm easily derailed. There's a reason we're doing a Swiss queue. I'm easily derailed. Time spiral, we're moving in. I missed out on the Palancron. No, I got Lions. We got a Lion's Eye Diamond, so it's okay. So there's Frantic Search, Restock, Wooded Foothills. The Time Spiral. We can take Regrowth. Good in green, blue. Splash white, splash black. Kozilek just seems a little bit pricey to cast in this deck. Look, we have Moments Peace and Cryptic and Upheaval. We're pretty like foggy. Okay, we'll take the Regrowth though. That seems like the play. Plateau, not looking to be red. Twilight Mire would be nice. Awakening Zone is just such a nice card, though. Any deck that's trying to ramp and cast Revelation, or is trying to chump block and maneuver that way, Awakening Zone is huge. So let's take it. Chroma's Vengeance. Not too interested in it because we actually have a decent amount of artifacts and such. I'm gonna take the Temple Garden. We get a little bit more fixing. I'd be more interested in a clean sweep, creature sweep. Dismantling Blow seems like a really nice sideboard card here, amongst a bunch of cards we aren't really looking to use. But as for our deck, still looking for a way to win, but we have some really fun cards that draw cards and such. And maybe the Brain Freeze will come back and everything will snap into focus. All right, I guess I'll take a red card. This one is kind of good against us. Whatever, there's a chance we'll play red and we'd want Slagstorm. Like, we have zero red fixing and zero red cards, but it's cube, it can happen. So, I was just saying I wanted a creature sweep. Go ahead. Jam it. Brain Freeze would be the next pack, huh? Okay, Heliod just seems too slow. Like, it just seems too slow. We don't have any devotion. It'd be a nice topper in a white weenie deck. I'm gonna take the brush land. Brain Freeze, Brain Freeze. Brain Freeze came back. We're doing it. We're in it. We're doing it. I can't help it. We're going. Restock, sure. And Ismaru, not really wanting to go against that. Turn one that bad. We get and the van.
Woo.